top 6 fastest robots in the world, Guinness World Records. On average, a human can run approximately 12 to 15 miles per hour. Not bad if you're chasing down an errant frisbee on a Sunday afternoon. But what about during an emergency? In moments like such, speed can often mean the difference between life and death. Add 60 pounds of protective gear and equipment that first responders often wear, and speed and agility become a sluggish afterthought. Is there anyone or anything else to turn to for a speedy rescue? Keep watching. Hi, my name is Alex, and welcome to AI News Daily. In this video, we bring you the top 6 fastest robots in the world today. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notifications. Let's get started. Number 6, CHEETAH, 28.3 miles per hour. Developed and tested by Boston Dynamics for DARPA's Maximum Mobility and Manipulation, or M3 program, CHEETAH had already worn the crown of the world's fastest robot with a land speed record of 18 miles per hour. However, records are made to be broken, and recently, CHEETAH did just that when it was clocked at 28.3 miles per hour on a treadmill, thus trumping Bolt's top speed by 0.51 miles per hour. My take on speed is that we are not trying to achieve extraordinary speeds, just trying to get legged robots into the speed range of other normal vehicles, Mark Ribert, president and founder of Boston Dynamics, wrote in an email to media sources. Similar to its animal inspiration, the CHEETAH's back flexes back and forth like an accordion, which increases its stride and running speed. What DARPA is doing with its robotics programs, explained DARPA program manager Dr. Gil Pratt in a press release, is attempting to understand and engineer into robots certain core capabilities that living organisms have refined over millennia of evolution: efficient locomotion, manipulation of objects, and adaptability to environments. Later this year, Boston Dynamics plans to start testing a free-running version of CHEETAH capable of operating on natural terrain. Number 5. Planar Biped, 13.1 miles per hour. Young MC wasn't the only one busting a move back in 1989. So was a posse of engineers and roboticists from MIT's Leg Lab who were busy creating a running man of a different sort, the Planar Biped. The Planar Biped was programmed by Jeff Coakling, now a chief scientist at Boston Dynamics, when he was working on his PhD thesis on the limits of robot running. The machine had 2 telescoping legs connected to the robot's body by pivot joints at the hips. Within each leg was a hydraulic actuator that worked together with springs to change the length of the robot's leg as it ran along its circular, boom-mounted path. Algorithms used to control the planar biped focused on operating one leg at a time. Because the idle leg was kept short until it sprang into action, the robot ran with an alternating or hopping gait and could even do flips. The engineers used what they learned from the planar biped to improve legged robots that followed. Number 4. Legged Squat Support System, LS3, 7 miles per hour. With speeds topping out at 7 miles per hour on flat surfaces, you may think you could outrun the LS3, but we'd think twice before challenging this robot to a race. For starters, to be fair, you'd need to strap on a 400-pound backpack, because that's how much weight the LS3 has been designed to carry. Developed for DARPA by Boston Dynamics, the untethered, hydraulically powered four-legged LS3 is designed to use computer vision, sensors, and GPS to follow soldiers on missions as a robotic pack mule of sorts. It's capable of relieving the squad's physical strain and fatigue by carrying over 4 times the weight of what an average soldier carries in gear. As the LS3 trots along over rough terrain, designers envision it will integrate with troops and interpret verbal and visual commands, similar to how a trained animal interacts with its handler. Additionally, the LS3 could be an auxiliary power source, capable of recharging batteries for radios and handheld devices. 3 levels of sensors make up the LS3's head and allow the quadruped to track its leader and other objects from as far away as almost 100 feet. In the bot's robust body is the engine, cooling fans, and cargo areas for gear. The LS3 may not have the physique of a sprinter, but what it lacks in speed, it makes up for in brawn. If Aesop's fable, The Tortoise and the Hare, taught us anything, it's that sometimes slow and steady wins the race. Number 3. MABEL, 6.8 miles per hour. With a peak speed of 6.8 miles per hour, MABEL is thought to be the world's fastest bipedal robot with knees. Like a human, it has a heavier torso with light, flexible legs equipped with springs. And, as a result, it has given Mabel a remarkably human-like gait. Mabel has large springs for energy storage, says Jesse Grizzle, Jerry and Carol Levin Professor of Engineering at the University of Michigan. They act like tendons in the human body, absorbing energy at leg impact and releasing energy when the robot is launching itself into the flight phase of running. Mabel was built in 2008 in collaboration with Jonathan Hurst, who then was a doctoral student at the Robotics Institute at Carnegie Mellon University. In the meantime, Grizzle and a variety of doctoral students from University of Michigan's Control Systems Lab have spent the last 4 years tweaking feedback algorithms to keep Mabel balanced while navigating its environment. Like a human runner, Mabel stays in the air for 40% of each stride, giving it the kind of gait suitable for speed. But not just speed for speed's sake. We're really concerned with creating a rescue robot, something that can go in a scenario where humans are working in a factory or living in a home, etc., and there's been a dangerous situation, Grizzle said. There's a reason firemen don't show up on horses when they go into a home or factory, because quadrupeds can't maneuver well in environments designed for upright walkers. Mabel was also funded by DARPA, along with the National Science Foundation. Grizzle and Hurst, now an assistant professor at Oregon State, are currently working on a robot that, unlike Mabel, will be untethered. Number 2. PETMAN, 4.4 miles per hour. If Mabel left you spellbound and unable to run, get a load of PETMAN's stride. You'll be so mesmerized by its natural human-like gait that it'll be able to outpace you, but just walking. Designed and fabricated by Boston Dynamics for the US Army and DARPA, the Protection Ensemble Test Mannequin is an anthropomorphic robot used to test clothing worn by soldiers for protection against chemical warfare. Standing nearly 6 feet tall and weighing 180 pounds, PETMAN's top speed is 4.4 miles per hour, which made it the fastest bipedal robot in the world before Mabel came along. But speed almost always plays second fiddle to the tethered robot's other talents. Thanks to hydraulic actuation and legs equipped with shock absorbers, PETMAN can move freely, walk, crawl, do squat thrusts, perform suit-stressing calisthenics, and balance itself on 2 feet when shoved. So, if keeping pace with the machines has left you so frustrated you're thinking about pushing them off the track, take a cue from PETMAN. The robots are just going to land back on their feet. Number 1. HAMR-JR. This little robot, inspired by insects, mainly cockroaches, can do incredible things. HAMR Jr. can just about squeeze onto the surface of a penny and weighs far less than a paperclip. But don't let its size fool you. This four-legged robot can also carry up to 10 times its own weight in cargo and hits top speeds that, for its size, are comparable to a cheetah bounding over the Serengeti. HAMR Jr. can turn right and left and even scoots backward. It also runs at a pace of nearly 14 of its own body lengths, or about 1 foot per second. For comparison, cheetahs, the speed demons of the mammal world, sprint at roughly 16 body lengths per second. HAMR Jr. is just the beginning, the makers have added. Engineers could, theoretically, use his team's same methods to make even more petite robots, the size of a pencil eraser or smaller. With that, we end this video. Consider subscribing to join in on our future content.